Hello, welcome to the Monday, April 5th, 2021 edition of the Sands and Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich, and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. Last week, Xavier wrote about how he came across some malware that took screenshots, and Xavier was able to recover many of the screenshots that the malware sent back to a command and control server. But Xavier noticed that some of these images did actually originate from sandboxes, not from actual end-user systems. And this was pretty evident, for example, if terminal windows were open that ran software that typically is used by sandboxes. So Xavier wrote a little Python script to determine how many of these screenshots came from sandboxes, and he ended up with about 21%. The main criteria Xavier did look for is the size of the screenshot and then also the percent of unified color, essentially how much of the screen is just one color. In a real system, you often have multiple windows open and icons and such, leading to a more colorful desktop, while of course in a sandbox you often don't have many windows open, usually a fairly plain wallpaper and the like, which then was identified as a sandbox. Now, just looking at some of the samples that Xavier posted, it looks like the script was pretty good in identifying sandboxes and characterizing those images. And the FBI, as well as the Cybersecurity Infrastructure Agency, CISA, are noticing an increase in the attacks against older FortiGate VPN gateways. The vulnerabilities being attacked here are CVE-2020-128-12, which was patched in July of last year, and then CVE-2018-13379, which also was patched in May of 2019. So patches have been available for a while now, and these vulnerabilities have always been exploited, so this is not really all that new. It does allow an attacker to essentially access credentials for the VPN and then connect to the VPN as an authenticated user. So, of course, short solution here, update FortiOS, and if you think you already did so, double check and make sure that you are actually on the latest version. It looks like the bad guys found yet another way to take advantage of GitHub Actions. GitHub Actions are used to automatically validate and check code as it's being checked in to a repository or submitted as a pull request. And the trick that attackers are using here is that they are forking a legitimate repository. They're then adding malicious code and submit a pull request. It does sometimes not even take an action from the administrator of the victim repository here. Instead, some of these GitHub actions can be used to check the code as the pull request is submitted. Whenever these actions are running, a virtual machine is created within GitHub's infrastructure, and this is where the malicious code then includes the CryptoCoin miner and essentially runs it within GitHub's infrastructure. In other cases, it may be necessary for an administrator to actually approve a pull request, so that depends a little bit in how the particular repository is set up. And the victim here is not so much the target repository that's being used as a vehicle here to execute these GitHub actions, but more so GitHub's infrastructure. And an unknown individual or group did publish 533 million records from Facebook. These are users' phone numbers, personal information like name, the origin city, the city they are living in some cases, also relationship status. Given the large amount of the data and the content, so for example, there are no passwords and such, they may be useful, for example, for social engineering attacks to then trick the victim into revealing additional information, maybe in some cases for password reset attacks, but also, for example, to hijack particular phone numbers, because the phone number being used here is typically the one that you set up with Facebook for password reset requests and the like. Overall, there's not much you can or really have to do in this case. Again, no passwords leak, so no need to necessarily change your password with Facebook at this point, but just some awareness, and that's probably also important to spread the word about, that this information could be used for some follow-on attacks. Well, and that's it for today. So thanks for listening and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.